Hello. Welcome once again. In this video, we will see how to add abilities to a character. Let's begin with creating a project named Character Movement. To animate your character, you will require the Animation Starter Pack, which is available to download for free from the Epic Games Marketplace. Click the free button to download and add the Animation Starter Pack to your Epic Games library. From your library, search for your Animation Starter Pack and click Add to Project. Then from the Select the Project to add the asset to the menu, search for and select your character movement project file, then click Add to Project. Upon adding the Animation Starter Pack to your project, you will notice its presence in the content browser. Now let's create the player character. A character class is required for your player to control. A character is a pawn that comes with a character movement component, to provide a locomotion system for humanoid characters to traverse through your world. First, click the Add Import button to create a new Blueprint character class, and name it BP underscore player character. Now double-click your BP underscore player character to open its class defaults. Then in the Components tab, select the mesh that is the character mesh, and then Skeletal Mesh component, and navigate to the Details panel. In the Mesh category, select the drop-down arrow adjacent to the Skeletal Mesh variable, and from the drop-down menu, select SK underscore mannequin. Again, in the Details panel, navigate to the Transform category, and set the mesh's location and rotation to 0, 0, and minus 90. Here your character's skeletal mesh will now be oriented in the direction of the forward-facing arrow component. Now, navigate to the Components tab to select your mesh component, then click Add Component and in the drop-down menu search for and select Spring Arm, then name your Spring Arm component, Spring Arm Comp. Now, navigate to the Details panel, and in the Camera Settings category enable the Use Pawn Control Rotation. Enabling the use of Pawn Control Rotation will rotate the camera relative to the spring arm. Then navigate to the Transform category and set the spring arm comp's location to 0, 0, and 50. Now go to the Camera category. Here, set the socket offset to 0, 0, and 30. With your spring arm comp selected, click the Add Component button, then in the drop-down menu search for and select Camera to add a camera component named Camera Comp. In the Components tab, select the Character Movement component, then navigate to the Details panel. And in the Character Movement, Rotation Settings, category, enable Use Controller Desired Rotation and Orient Rotation to Movement. In the Character Movement, Walking category enable the Ignore Base Rotation variable. Setting Ignore Base Rotation to True will tell the character to maintain its current world rotation, and ignore any changes in the rotation of the base it's standing on. In the Character Movement Nav Movement category, navigate to the Movement Capabilities and select the drop-down arrow to reveal additional variable settings, navigate to the Can Crouch Boolean and click to enable it. Now compile and save. Now let's create input key mappings and input movement events. You will need to set up some custom logic that will move your character when an input key, such as W, A, S, or D is pressed. So, navigate to Edit, then Project Settings, and then Input. Then in the Bindings category, click the plus sign next to Action Mappings to add the Jump with Key Value Spacebar. Then Crouch with Key Value Left Control. And lastly, Sprint with Key Value Left Shift. Now, in the bindings category, click the plus sign next to axis mappings to add the movements to axis mappings. Name move forward allot key value W and S, and set the scale to 1.0 and minus 1.0. Then add in name move right, allot key value D and A, and set the scale as 1.0 and minus 1.0. Then add another in name turn, allot key mouse X, and set the scale to 1.0. And lastly add in name lookup, and allot key mouse Y and set minus 1.0. So the final mapping looks like this. The character can now walk, run, turn, look up down, move around, sprint and couch. So here we wrap the input key mappings. In the coming video, we will see how to integrate the input movement events. Thanks for watching. Please like this video if you found it helpful and informative. Also, subscribe to our channel for more updates and tutorials.